you. Good evening. This song,
you'll pay the cost, so get right.
tonight. See a lot of you coming. Now can we do that one again?
Yeah.
Okay. As long as I got your permission. Take it away, man. Thank you. last song. Two. The first album called The Harvest.
Thank you. Thank you. say you miss or misunderstand at a time such as this. Because if such close friends should ever fall out, what would there be left for fighting about? the jumping up and down again.
Jump up and down!
And take it away.
Thank you. Boy, I saw the point after that. All right.
You're down at the top there, all right.
Thank you.
And Lincoln Wonderwall and Greg Jeffrocks. And high school started with keyboards.
Thank you.
Good. Ready for a little blast from the past now? That cheery one? Good.
Thank you.
was a little tune called
I'm not sure you set on the road and you stay from the grave.
Thank you.
Wish you were here.
How's about a little hand and a little ensemble here for Jody Lindskog on percussion. Chris Slade on the drums. Mickey Fears on the bass guitar. Mick Ralphs on the guitar. Local boy from Toronto, Greg Decker on the keyboards. And Raph Ravenscroft on the saxophone. How about David Gilmour?
Did you get rid of all the voices in your mind?
Thank you. Thank you.
for 55.
This one's a special for you. Thank you, Toronto.
I can't put my finger on it. thank you all for coming. Stay around. All right, thank you. Thank you up top there.
Thank you very much.
David Gilmour.
On Chum FM, and this is Rick Ringer.
And thank you, Larry Wilson. A busy start to the week with two different Chum FM presentations tonight. We'll hear from all the artists involved in just a moment. For that, Chum FM presents the first of two nights at Massey Hall with Pink Floyd guitarist David Gilmour and the impressive new Liverpool trio Icicle Works. They'll start the show at 8 as they have the other Gilmour concerts in North America. And Icicle Works leader Ian McNabb told me...
It's going very well, surprisingly well, actually, because we did some dates with the Pretenders before we started doing the Gilmour stuff, and we were going down really well, but the reaction was nowhere near as good as what we've got with the Gilmour audience, which is, you know, nobody knows why that is. Somebody
You'd think it'd be just the opposite, actually.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Somebody said to us that opening for David Gilmour must be like, you know, being thrown to a pack of lions because they're such rabid Floyd types, you know, that surely haven't got a chance. But we go down really well. Maybe we're ripping off Pink Floyd more than we actually believe we are.
A lot of influences there you never realised. Yeah.
A lot of people say, who haven't seen us live, oh, there's no way that you three guys are going to create as big a sound as that on stage. Surely you must use tapes and everything. But we don't. We originally toyed with the idea of getting a fourth member in, but it didn't seem to work, right? When the three of us work so well on stage, because I'd play like guitar and keyboards, so it's like there's lots of drums and the bass player's playing bits of percussion and we're all doing two jobs, you know. But it's quite exciting to see on stage, and if we got another member in, perhaps we'd relax a little, you know.
By the way, Icicle Works will be back to do their own show, probably at the Alma Combo, and probably in July. Tonight's headliner at Massey Hall, of course, is David Gilmour on his first solo tour of North America, and yes, he is playing at least a couple of Floyd numbers. Ever since his second solo album was released, there's been lots of talk about whether Pink Floyd is an entity as a group anymore, and Gilmour insists it is, although he and Roger Waters don't have any immediate plans for Floyd. Here, Gilmour discusses with Roger Bartel the falling out he had with Waters over the making of the Final Cut LP.
Due to various circumstances, the timing and things wasn't good, and we actually got into some arguments. Well, I mean, we always get into arguments, but we got into such a state of argument about the Final Cut because Roger wanted it to be one way, and I thought he was doing it the wrong way.
You wanted it as a soundtrack, did you not?
No. I didn't want it to be a soundtrack. We were agreed on what we were trying to do was to make a Pink Floyd album when we made that decision. We made that decision together. We all agreed on that. My disagreement was just that I didn't think the material was good enough for a Pink Floyd album, apart from three songs. I thought three songs were really good. And what I wanted to do was stop for a little while, write material, get my demos together and Roger to work on some stuff for a little while, and then get back together with more stuff to choose from and make a very good album. Roger didn't want to do that. Our arguing became counterproductive, and so I agreed to stop working on the production, just say, okay, you make the record, I'll come and play whatever you want me to do, whenever you want me to do it, but you just get on and finish the album, because it's not just like banging our heads against a wall. And so that's what happened. He finished the album off.
David Gilmour playing the first of his two solo shows at Massey Hall tonight. You might find some tickets at the Massey box office, although less than 100 remained as of 5 o'clock. There are also a few remaining for tomorrow night's show at Massey. We'll have concert reports before and after Gilmour's set tonight, wrapping it up with an About-Face Super Session on Roger's show at 10:30. Birthday.